I first of all love weird old patent drawings. There are so many odd things about them. Sometimes they look like the inventor. My early patent drawing looks like my long 70s hair, you know. For some reason, the patent illustrator drew me, you know. So you have an idea of the ghosts of these inventors, which is creepy enough by themselves, you know. I've been a fan of Stanley Kubrick since I began thinking about movies. Kubrick got to see the demo we made for the Steadicam, which was 30 impossible shots. I liked handheld. I did not like the way it looked then or now. And so what I needed was a way to disconnect the camera from the person. The great thing about that invention is you can shoot something that anybody in the business will know is impossible. It went, quote, viral in 35 millimeter. Copies of it went around the world and was seen by, you know, everybody that was anybody in the business. Kubrick saw the reel and sent a telex that gave me chills to read. And the telex said, should revolutionize the way films are shot. You can count on me as a customer. Very Kubrickian sentence that followed said, oh, by the way, if you're interested in protecting it, there are 14 frames of film that show a shadow of it on the ground with something slowly rotating, but my lips are sealed, he said. Of course, we darted into the screening room, and by God, he was right. We had to cut those frames out of the demo. And then it, enigmatically at the end, he said, is there a minimum height at which it could be used? That led to us inventing something called low mode, and he immediately decided to use it on the film he was prepping, hence the question, what's the minimum height? Because he was about to shoot Danny Lloyd and The Shining. It hadn't occurred to me that Kubrick loves to do multiple takes. And the idea of me running, for example, after Danny on his big wheel, yours truly at age 34 or whatever, would have gotten about three passes around that hotel and I could have been sent home in a pillowcase. So we had to invent ways of doing it, and we invented vehicle shots. And the winning object was a wheelchair that Kubrick had had made for himself so that he could be wheeled along shooting handheld. And I managed to hard mount the low mode Steadicam on that so the lens was 1 inch above the floor, which is a stunning, wonderful place for the lens. And that film cemented the usefulness of the Steadicam for all time. That film was where I learned my trade, you know. All those takes were brilliant for me.
Slowly,
keep coming. And there's something about the quality of the motion of the Steadicam in that film, which is supernaturally smooth, that doesn't feel like a normal objective movie moving shot, which are, you know, God's eye view, the director's eye view, whatever. They feel like the hotel's eye view. They have a faintly diabolical quality, and I think it depends on the steadiness, the supernatural steadiness of those shots. Coming around those corridors chasing Danny, and seeing the two little girls there, you know, I got the hair on the back of my neck stood up, I can tell you.
Hello, Danny.
That's part, I think, of why the film remains frightening.
Come and play with us, Daddy.